For 40 years, I've been pursuing just one goal: to develop the most fertile soil in the world. During a trip to the Amazon region in 2010, I was able to understand for the first time why the legendary Terra Preta is the key to humanity's survival. It is not only about permanently fertile soils, but also about binding CO2 and thus a very powerful tool in the fight against climate change. Since that time, we have known that biochar is the most important component of Terra Preta, and we have started producing biochar and this fertile soil. With a new plant concept, we have successfully developed a blueprint for a perfect circular economy in compost and soil plants. Our plant is an absolute innovation in Europe and the first of its kind on an industrial scale. It is now being tested and further improved in real operation as part of an EU LIFE project. This technology will then be rolled out across Europe. Here you can see the raw material for biochar production. Many tests and scientific experiments have shown that every biochar is different and that we also need minerals that adhere firmly to the biochar. The so-called biochar mineral complex, especially for the production of soil. This has improved binding sites for nutrients and above all provides a more optimal habitat for the desired microbiology. The wood screening from composting are the perfect raw material for the production of this high quality biochar or biochar mineral complex, because these necessary minerals are already attached on the surface. The problem up to now was that there was no suitable carbonization plant for processing these screenings and that the necessary preparation had not yet been developed. Actually, we needed to incinerate the screening residues as we could not treat them, but now we found the solution. The sieve residues can now be processed in several stages. First, a complete drying with available excess heat from pyrolysis. Second, screening with plastic extraction and magnetic separator. Third, a water bath for 100% separation of stones and heavy materials. Fourth, manual sorting after the water bath. Fifth, shredding with a commercially available chipping machine. Sixth, mixing with other organic residues, such as sunflower husks, to increase the variety of input materials and therefore also the variety of binding sites on the resulting biochar. Seventh, safety screening and homogenization. Here you can see the biomass bunker. The mixed biomass is fed into the transfer bunker, which is designed as a moving floor in the direction of the transport screw and simultaneously dries the raw material on the way there. The excess heat from the pyrolysis process is again used at the drying air. For this purpose, the drying bunker was equipped with a buffer wall. The biomass must be pushed under this wall and lies behind it at a defined bulk high of maximum 70 centimeters. Warm air flows evenly through this layer so that the biomass is completely dried, 95% of dry matter content. At the end, it takes only around 2 to 3 days. This concept means that even every wet raw material can be mixed in and used as a carbonization raw material. From here, the dried biomass is continuously transported to the pyrolysis reactor via numerous screws, conveyors, and a small storage container. This paralysis oven was developed by the company NGE from Upper Austria, and we had the opportunity to contribute our large experience from 12 years of practical operation with another smaller system. Hereby, we were primarily concerned with simplicity, robustness, and above all, a reliably high quality of the biochar. All these requirements could be now implemented to 100% with this new technology by NGE. The biomass falls from above via a rotary valve into the pyrolysis reactor. This essentially consists of just two large screws, conveyors, that transport the biomass through the combustion chamber of the furnace in a closed pipe. At the end of this transport screw, the finished biochar falls into a cross screw and is discharged. The resulting pyrolysis gas is sucked into the combustion chamber at the same end of the screw, and here it is mixed with a lot of air and burns around this screw at 900 to 1100 degrees Celsius. The entire reactor is controlled fully automatically using only the temperature and negative pressure. The following facts are very important. First, the fresh biochar can never cool down in the furnace. This means that the pollutants contained in the gas can never adhere to the biochar. Second, the resulting gas, including all pollutants such as PAHs and PFAS, etc., is completely burned in the combustion chamber with excess oxygen. Third, no energy needs to be supplied. The system heats itself and also supplies around 500 to 600 kilowatt of heat per unit. To put it simply, this pyrolysis oven can handle any fuel and produces clean biochar instead of ash. The obtained biochar is transported to the biochar bunker for cooling via many screw conveyors and stored here temporarily. Here I stand in front of our first biochar bunker, where the black gold, our high-quality biochar, continuously trickles out. On the right side, the nitrogen-loaded biochar is collected. When we produce biochar for soil activator, nitrogen is sprayed onto the biochar immediately after production. Additionally, we have installed a grinding technique here in the background. The coarsest grind is less than 1 millimeter. We can go even finer, down to 10 micrometers. These special biochars are used for specific applications like geopolymers, plastic manufacturing, fillers and dyes. To operate this plant economically, we had to develop a sophisticated heat utilization concept. The resulting energy, which comes from the combustion of pyrolysis gases, is used 3 times in our new plants. First, for the pyrolysis process itself. Second, we cool it down to 300 degrees and use it for our sewage sludge drying process. The exhaust air, which comes out from the drying process, is cooled down from 70 degrees to 40 degrees with this heat exchanger here. And in this way, we bring most of the energy back into a hot water circuit. This energy is used for our drying box and for drying the feedstock for the pyrolysis process. After the heat exchanger, the exhaust air passes into the acid scrubber. The acid scrubber is necessary because there is a lot of ammonia in the exhaust air from our sewage sludge drying system, and we can wash out it with this scrubber and produce ammonia sulfate in this way. We produce around 80 tons of nitrogen per year in this way and use it to enrich our biochar or sell it as nitrogen fertilizer to farmers. The cleaned exhaust air is then routed into the biofilter to remove any remaining odors. Thanks to the co-financing support of the EU LIFE program, we were able to realize an industrial large-scale installation and above all an ingenious overall circular concept, which serves now as a blueprint for the other thousands of composting plants in Europe. In our technical setting, we have combined two pyrolysis ovens with three sewage sludge drying systems to form a single unit. The entire waste gas flow from both furnaces is fed into a collecting pipe and is taken over by the three dryers as required. The idea behind this is that the entire system continues to run, regardless of which part of the system is currently at a still stand for serving and repairs. In extreme cases, the system can therefore be operated with just one kiln and one dryer. With this plant, we will produce more than 1,200 tons of dry mass biochar per year and store the carbon forever instead of emitting it to the air. At least 2,000 tons of CO2 binding certificates can be obtained. And not to forget, at the same time, at least 10,000 tons of sewage sludge will be dried, and during this process, around 80 tons of nitrogen every year can be recovered. Our new carbonization plant has closed many loops in the compost and soil plant, and at the same time, actively protects the climate. First, the waste problem of compost screenings has been solved 100%. Even plastic contamination is not a problem because plastic is completely gasified and then used as energy. Second, due to their mineral content, compost screenings are the perfect raw material for very high quality biochar in the soil and concrete sector. Third, the plant is completely self-sufficient in terms of heat energy and supplies around 1 megawatt of surplus heat. Fourth, this heat is reused several times after pyrolysis for drying sewage sludge separately and a second time for drying biomass and heating up all our buildings. Fifth, at the same time, we recover nitrogen, which in turn is used to recharge the biochar, or the surplus is sold to the agricultural sector as fertilizer. Six, we fix and store carbon by producing biochar from organic residues. It is stable in soil for thousands of years, and so we reduce greenhouse gases emissions and generate CO2 certificates, which are another income to make circular systems more economically viable. Seven, the biochar produced reaches the highest quality level. It's EBC Agro Organic. Many thanks to the whole team from our EU LIFE project. At first, NGE Next Generation Energy for developing this great pyrolysis stuff. Second to Carstor-Con, which will develop an amendment for concrete production. Third, company Charlen, our Toto company, which produce high-quality feed char and manure char. And last but not least, to Bastu Consult, Mr. Patrick Stumm, who helped to bring us together and look very carefully that everything goes in the right direction. Thank you very much.